They were the good old days at school, weren't they, guys? Getting in the occasional fight, spending heaps of time with your friends.
Yeah, remember games like Sex On, All Over Red Rover, and Stations.
Oh, and Elastics.
Stations, is that like an Adelaide thing? I've
heard. Well, it's a great game, primary school.
Well, enough about your time in the Big Brother house. It's Friday, it's 7:30, it's Kids Sports
Night.
We're It's Friday night games. Give me them back.
Tonight, we raise more than just the stakes. After a night in the sack, it's time for a big breakfast. And then, it's off to school. If it's excitement you're after, then we've got the stuff to quench your thirst. Stick with us and have a ball.
The show that's turned Friday night into the best part of the weekend. My name's Mike Goldman, and tonight the Idols take on the Country Bumpkins. And I guarantee in the next hour and a half you're going to see celebrities fall faster than Mark Philippoussis's tennis ranking. Before we meet the teams that will engage in tonight's strenuous skirmishes, I should first introduce you to two of my trusty companions. First up, a girl who's hotter than a $20 TV set. The very beautiful Brie Amar. You look spectacular.
Mwah. Oh, thank you.
Okay, and a man who's had so many sporting injuries that if he were a horse, he'd have been shot more times than rapper 50 Cent. Mr. Ryan Fitzy Fitzgerald. Fitzy, did you get a little bit of a pash there?
I got a pash from a young lady down there. Thank you. There she is. Look at that.
Look at her down there.
You lucky girl.
She's won Friday night games.
Got a bit of yellow paint there, mate.
Have I?
Yes.
Nice.
Well, welcome along. Good to see you both.
Thank you.
How's your week been?
Fantastic, as always.
And what about you?
Mate, pumps. Finals. Finals time.
Finals time.
Can you smell the grass? It's finals time.
We don't have grass. It's like a rubbery pitch thing.
It certainly is.
Well, as we've said, tonight is a special Friday night games. Obviously, Fitzy, it's the first preliminary final, the Idols and the Country Bumpkins.
Yes, it sure is. They are going head-to-head tonight, guys. They are hungrier, the challenges are harder, the stakes are higher, the dreams are closer, and the introductions contain more adjectives than we've ever had before. Both teams have earned their place here tonight, but making it to the grand final is not going to be very easy at all, Mikey, I'm telling you.
Definitely not. What are they playing for, Bree?
Well, the winners tonight will only be one step away from winning the $50,000 for the charity of their choice, courtesy of Super Cheap Auto.
Super Cheap Auto.
Yep. I tell you what, they have a bigger heart than Farlap. Hey, and speaking of charities, there's a new charity out at the moment, guys.
Yeah.
Get on board. It's called the Ryan Fitzgerald Charity, and they're doing great work for local pubs and fast food restaurants around Australia. Get behind it.
I know just where to put the donations. Blind slot right there.
Damn me, great.
Back from our first show, in the gold corner, singing for their supper and karaoke-ically cool, we have the already once victorious Idols.
Well, they came out firing on all four cylinders, but stalled horribly on the starting line. Unable to even finish the first game, it looked like it was Big Brother versus the Little Sisters. During the memory game, the penny dropped, and they remembered what they've come here for, to win.
Can I just say, they've had a win now, they are oozing confidence.
At one game apiece, the stakes were high in the next game, but the other team were no match against the skill and grace of these mighty Idols. A controversial end for these naughty sausages, but they took the barbecue trophy.
And Idols are the winners!
Please welcome back the Australian Idols, team leader Millsy, dashing Daniel Spillane and marvellous Millie Edwards.
Let me squeeze in. Come on, you've got to share the podium now, you lot. Now, Daniel Spillane, tell me, how did you pull up after the last lot of games you played?
Very, very sore, but I've recovered from those injuries. Well, most of them anyway.
Right. I heard a rumour today that you're actually trying to prep for tonight by watching Cinderella in your hotel room.
Cinderella Man.
Oh, right. You're going to throw some punches tonight?
Good little buzz there for Russ. Go on, mate.
Nice, nice. Now, Millie, what have you been doing in preparation for tonight? Training hard?
Yeah, well, look, I had to get a personal trainer. It's just really tough out here.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Crazy stuff. And Millsy. Whose butt do you really want to whip tonight?
All of them out there. Actually, Adam Brown, he's getting a bit lippy backstage. Very lippy. He's talking about his V8 utes. He's talking it up.
Nice. Well, how do you reckon we're going to go, guys? We're going to win!
And back in the green corner for the second time is the team who puts the tree in country. The already once victorious, the mighty Country Bumpkins!
Go the green team!
They came out firing and proved that they were not afraid to get their hands dirty. After a win in round one, they got their tops knocked off in the second game, but that'd be the last time they'd be defeated on that night. They smashed the dummies in round three, and in game four, crossed the line like a couple of thoroughbreds. Give or take the odd hiccup.
Mate, it's just another romantic evening on the farm, you know.
And will you please welcome back the country team with their fearless leader, Adam Brown, the wonderful Wendy Slack Smith, and the gorgeous Glenn from Big Brother.
Get up here, boys. I tell you what, you got another cheer score tonight. Adam Brand, mate, heat one. You were magnificent. He's your team leader tonight, Adam Brand. And, mate, you're a musician. You do a lot of stuff individually, but you guided these guys very well. How was that power of being the team leader?
Oh, look, mate, we had a fantastic team. We had an awesome cheer squad up there. Tonight, we've leaned up a little bit. We've had a bit of time off. We're leaned up, we're mean, and we're ready to go.
Now, Glenn from Big Brother, last time we were here, mate, they were getting stuck into you. They said the shearer was going to get shorn. But I tell you what, that's when you started coming out of your shell a bit. Anyone in that team you want to get stuck into tonight?
Yeah, Millsy. Millsy's going down.
Millsy! Now, do you like Australian Idol, Glenn? You like these singers?
Nah, not tonight.
Not tonight. And Wendy, it's been a few weeks since you were here last. What have you been doing? You been keeping yourself fit?
Yeah, I've been harvesting, so that's keeping me taut, trim. No worries.
Oh, harvesting. That would have to keep you fit. Well, can everyone please put your hands together for the winners tonight?
So they are our celebrities, but what about our celeb-to-bees? The most famous, not-so-famous people in Australia. With the country team tonight is the frisky mother of 10, yes, 10, Jackie from Country Queensland. And with the idol team, Christy from Moldsland. And this is how they came to be celeb-to-bees. Our addition to the Australian Idol team had to tie knots on a piece of rope while riding Dreamworld's scream machine, the Claw. Christy may have unravelled that challenge, but how did she handle sinking her teeth into a barrel of onions in search for a hidden flag?
Yeah,
oh,
there's the winner!
That's a turn ahead.
Beautiful!
While Christy got to know her new teammates a little better, Jackie was trying to win a place in the country team by counting how long it took to plummet 119 metres on the world's tallest freefall ride, Dreamworld's Giant Drop. Jackie's heart was still intact, but could she keep her head together while trying to attach as many pegs as possible to it?
Nine, ten.
So that means this girl over here is the winner. With 12, Jackie! Celeb-to-bees, Jackie and Christy!
Nice. Hey, Christy, I have to ask this. It's been a while since you were on the show last, and I want to know, you know, you're a celeb-to-be. Are you getting recognised in the street?
Yeah, I seem to have more friends now.
Great. Yeah, that's really good news. You should watch them. What about you, Fitzy?
I tell you what, Jackie, she joined the country team. Hey, funny enough, you should join them because you are a country girl yourself, aren't you, Jack?
Yep.
Now, the last time we found out that you are a mother of 10 children, 5 weeks ago you were on the show. Have you had any more kids since then?
No, I haven't, but I just will clarify, I've only had 5 children and I've got 5 foster children at home.
Oh, what a legend. Put your hands together for Jack.
How good is she? She wins.
Well, there you have it.
people, both teams think they're going to be victorious. One team is spot on, the other has delusions of adequacy. Which is which? You're about to find out. 10 points are up for grabs in the first game. I like to call it Junior Sports Relay.
It's Kids Sports Night, Fitzy.
Oh, my favourite day of the year in primary school, Bree.
I know. And what better way to start it off than with a relay race?
Hey, race one, sack race. Look how easy I got Bree into the sack.
Let's start it off, Bree.
Yeah,
it's pretty simple, pretty easy to explain. Part one of the relay, the sack race, and they're all in the same sack.
Now, they all have to go through the sack, over to these obstacles and down to this first finishing line. There's part one, down the drain.
Part two is the oversized egg and spoon race.
Have a look at this egg and spoon. Now, important. All four members have to be behind that red line and they have to carry it on their shoulders.
Don't you feel sorry for the chicken that laid that?
Oh, yes.
coming down, guys, if the egg falls off, only the person at the very back of the spoon can go back to retrieve it.
Now, where do they have to put the egg when they get down to this finish line, bro?
Of course, in the egg cup.
Right, yes.
Rightio. And the last part is the apple bobbing.
Oh, apple bobbing. Legendary. Now, there's 8 apples in there. They only need 1 apple each. Now, the clock is going to stop when each person has an apple and they're back on that line there.
That's exactly right. Back to you, Mikey.
Thank you, guys. Before we get started, it's time to meet the unhappiest member of our happy family. A man so mean, he sets rabbit traps on his lawn during Easter. Please put your hands together for the lean, mean, rule-keeping machine. As far as Friday night games go, he is the law, the ref. Oh, he's an angry man. He's got a face like a bulldog chewing
mate,
a wasp.
Look, there's a lot of people that hate you out there, mate.
Toss the coin to decide who gets to choose whether or not they want to go first or second tonight. Go for it, ref.
Okay, here we go.
Green the country!
So what, mate?
Adam Brand, turn around to the camera here, son. You have won the toss. What are you going to do? Go first or second?
Nah, we're going to send the poor little idols in first. We'll have a look at them.
You little beauty, back to your corner, son.
Okay, game one, Junior Sports Relay. Get ready, it's game on!
Oh, good start. No good.
No good.
This is a massive team effort here. They're bouncing around all over the shop.
In the sack, over the hay.
Mikey, I've not seen a sack bounce around like that since Matt Shervington ran his last 100 metres. There they go.
Hey, Fitzy, I haven't seen that many people in a sack since we did Big Brother.
Now, obviously, it's all about jumping in unison, but the idols are struggling at the moment. A bit like they're singing.
There they go, out of the sack now. They've got to grab the egg and spoon. Someone must place the egg on the spoon, and they all must get behind the red line on the spoon and carry it through the obstacle course.
Now, this is great preparation for the country Bumpkins. Have a look at the Bumpkins then, just watching here, what's going on, seeing how hard it is.
That is actually the same spoon that Fitzy's mum spoon-fed him as a child.
Whoop.
Oh, Milza, you get over here. Get behind the line.
Oh, come on, Idols, don't let me down. Come on, team.
Milzy.
Oh, Milzy can't. Up. He's got to keep the egg on the back there. They've got to bounce
Milzy,
it.
Milzy, get over behind the line before you move.
That ref sounds extra angry tonight.
Right,
Milzy's
there.
Oh, they've dropped it. The back person is Milzy. He's the only one that can put the egg back on the spoon. Oh!
This game kind of lost popularity after they invented the egg carton, didn't it?
That's better. Now they've got it down.
Scrambled eggs for dinner tonight if that falls off again.
That's it.
In the egg.
I'm going to put it in the apple bobbing. No, it actually goes in the egg cup.
Hands behind your backs.
Yeah. Now, the clock will not stop until everyone's got an apple here. And behind the line.
Oh, Millsy's got one.
Oop, there's Daniel's line.
Well, the bigger the mouth, the easier it is to get the apple.
Millie, she's chasing.
Come on, Millie, you should be able to get two apples in that mouth.
Poor girls, it's not very ladylike.
It's about trapping it in the corner, but the girls have got it stuck in the corner at the moment.
It's all about technique. Maybe she should try sucking it up.
Get off. Get off.
It is. Well, you've got to get it to the edge of the tank, don't you, boys?
I think there's only about four or five apples left in there, but the girls are struggling. That's it. Share the four down there, girls. There's five down there.
Big breath, big breath.
Come on, girls. This is important. Get the pace up.
It's not easy, apple bobbing, is it, Fitzy? Did you ever play it as a kid?
No, very hard.
There you go, bye.
Okay, I think you can let it out now, Millie. Now, was that a lot harder than it looked?
Yep.
Did you ever play this game as a kid, or did these kind of stop once they invented the PlayStation?
Never done it, but I feel like I'm like drowning.
All right, you're not going to make your kids do it?
No, never.
Definitely not. All right, Mikey, back to you.
Okay, there you go, Fitzy. 3 minutes and 18 seconds. Not a bad time.
It's deplorable.
You reckon?
The Bumpkins have got it down pat now. They've just watched him.
Okay. Well, that's what the country Bumpkins need to be. I'll see you on the other side of the break, otherwise you get a D-. This is Friday Night Game. Experience and extensive training. The ref is so dedicated to the refereeing way of life, he does it on the weekends. He's qualified to referee all the big events, from the legendary Carpet Super Bowls to the famous National Thumb War Competition. And the highly prestigious and world-renowned Fall Down Really Fast Championships.
It's not a joke, it's the law.
Express lane item counter by day. Friday night games by night. Be afraid, be very afraid of the ref.
11, this is not the express lane. Get to the other end.
Friday Night Games preliminary grand final. It's Kids Sports Night, and I'm joined by the beautiful Bree and a couple of my buddies. Hey. The Country Bumpkins are battling it out against the Idols for a place in the grand final and an ultimate prize pot of $50,000 charity dollars, which is enough prize money for 25,000 tuck shop lunches.
Really?
So they'll be worth $2 each.
Oh, I can't believe you had to think about that.
Well, that's smart. So for the Idols, yeah, they got to work pretty hard. They did work pretty hard. So how do you reckon the Country Bumpkins are going to go, Bree?
Look, I reckon they're going to struggle. But, you know, look at the team leader they've got. Can I show you something I found earlier?
Yeah, okay.
Check this out. This is Fitzy when he was little.
Actually, that's when he was under 9. And speaking of Kids Sports Night, which it is tonight, in 1986, Ryan Fitzgerald won the Australian title for long jump at 4.73 metres, and he still holds the record today.
Except now he actually is 4.73 metres.
But apparently by winning it, all he did was fall over and stand up again. So he was very tall as a child. Okay, here you go, Fitzy.
Oh, look, Mike, geez, I'm blushing. I wanted you to keep that under your Von Dutch, but if you want to bring it up with the nation, that's fine. I still hold that too, 20 years. Hey, I'm down here. Actually, we were just talking before. They were talking tactics, 3:18. That is a walk in the park for the Bumpkins, I reckon, today. Glenn, tactics, you just watch the Idols. What do you reckon? Keep on your feet.
Yeah, mate, stay on the feet and just go hard.
And what about the egg and spoon race down there? I think it's where they had their problems. How are you going to tackle that one?
Oh, no, we'll just beat them, though.
All right, he's fired up. Get it going, Mike.
Okie dokie. It's Junior Sports Relay Part 2. Country Bumpkins, get ready. It's game on!
Oh, good start.
Sorted.
You're really showing them there, Shearer.
That's a massive sack. How many potatoes do you reckon you could fit in that sack? At least 1,000. They're just not in unison. Didn't they see the idols do it? They should count. Listen to them count together.
Oh, great effort for the Bumpkins.
Over to the spoon.
Yeah, this is the hard one. The second part of the race here.
King Kong can play the spoons on that.
It's all about balance. All about balance.
This, come on, this week. We'll have a minute silence for the chicken that laid the egg.
Now, Glenn's at the back. He's the only one that can put the egg on.
He's an egg professional.
Oh, off she goes again.
See, they're just going too hard, too fast. It's not working.
Look at Glenn. He's front and square, though. He's picking up extra kicks.
You've got to put it exactly.
This is an excellent effort, Mike.
Exactly, Bree.
You're waiting until Glenn's on.
So exciting.
Get it over the line.
Wait until Glenn is on.
And then they've got to get it into the egg cup.
Oh, what? Come on, they're country Bumpkins. They should be able to ride horses and have good balance. Okay, they've got the egg in the egg cup. Now they're going for the apple bobbing.
Now, in the country, TV, would you? So they would have done plenty of these sorts of things.
Have a look at Adam Branch. He's going in bash and crash.
Ref, keep an eye on this, ref.
Hey,
two down.
That's two. I reckon this time's pretty good. This is going to be close.
Both feet on the ground. No.
Suck it in, Adam Brand.
At least he's putting everything into it. He's fearless.
Come on, Jackie. You got to use your height, Jack.
Jackie asked the lead to be having a little bit of trouble. Adam Brand taking his break.
Jackie could be the idol's saving grace here, really.
Oh, losing the helmet. Is that legal, ref?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, the idol fans aren't happy with that, but
have a look at Adam Brand.
He's going to the ground.
Jackie, she's got a bit of a height disadvantage here. She's only a little one, and I tell you what,
she's
it
so short.
If you can get up.
Poor old Jackie, she's so short you can see her feet in her driver's license photo.
I'll tell you what, there's nothing better than a good wet t-shirt from on a Friday. It's all right, Jack, you've got plenty of time, love.
Jack asked the lead to be, I hate to say this, but she's letting the team down.
No, she's.
This could be quite close.
A little bit shorter than everyone, poor Jack. She's got it! Oh, I tell you what, good effort there. This is going to be very, very close, Wendy. I tell you what, but good effort, guys. You didn't panic there at the end. Even though, have a look at the size of poor Jack to everyone else. She had to jump up there and get in there, but Wendy, you were straight onto that apple. You can finish that off after. How do you feel?
Pretty good. Well, that's the only way I get a feed as a little tacker, so plenty of training.
Apple body, and you're confident you're going to win this one, Wendy?
Oh, I've got it in the bag.
We have got this in the bag. Back to you, Mikey.
Yeah, well, they seem to think they've got it in the bag, so I reckon I might read out the times here. Country music guys down there, Adam Brand and his team. Now, I might read out the Idol's score first. The Idol's time was 3 minutes 18.
3 minutes 18.
So, Adam and his Country Bumpkins need to get a better time than that.
Oh, the suspense is killing me.
Do you think they got a better time?
Nah.
Well, unfortunately, their time was 3 minutes and 1 second, so they beat them. They won. Well, fortunately.
Heavens! Close, guys, so close.
And let's take a look at the action replay in the finishing seconds, how they did it. Adam Brand using the tongue, tonguing the apple and losing the helmet. That worked for him in the end, didn't it? So let's take a look at the Friday Night Games scoreboard. There you go, the country team, the Bumpkins, on 10 points.
Not for long, Mikey, I tell ya.
And on Kids Sports Night, the dummies in the corner are the idols with 0 points. Oh, well,
dummies isn't very nice.
Well, the dummies, you know, you sit in the dunces. You sit in the corner.
Thank
it's Kids
you.
Sports
That's
Night.
A little bit better.
I don't mean that they're actually dummies. Coming up, you'll see contestants of all shapes and sizes battle it out to be the teacher's pet. We're off to cut the crust off our sandwiches. This is Friday Night Games. Stay where you are. Back in a moment. That's right, the first preliminary finals of Friday Night Games. The Country Bumpkins are having a scuffle with the Idols for a place in the grand final and an ultimate prize of $50,000 to the charity of their choice.
Nice.
I'm Mike Goldman, and these are my co-hosts. One takes forever to get ready, and the other one is the lovely Bree.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's real funny, Mike. Well
Fitzy,
done.
Remind us who's on your team here for Kids Sports Night.
On the Country Bumpkins tonight, I want you to put your hands together. We've got Adam Brand, Wendy Slack Smith, we got Glenn from Big Brother, and the celeb to be the Frisky Jackie.
Bree, who's on your team?
Well, I've got the Idols, Millsy, Millie Edwards, Dance Spillane, and celeb to be Christy.
Take a look at the scoreboard, see how the teams are going so far. The scores stand at 10 to the Country Bumpkins and 0 to the Idols.
So that means the Bumpkins are winning.
Whoa. Nice.
Okay, it's Junior Sports Night and our next round is called SPELLINGBEE.
Mate, don't call me that, Mike. We're on national television. That's disgraceful.
I didn't.
Round two tonight, 10 points up for grabs. It's the great old spelling bee. Remember those in primary school, Bree?
Yeah, I was very bad at them, actually.
I was disgraceful as well. This one's pretty basic tonight. Mikey Goldman's going to come down here, and he's going to write words on this blackboard. Now, they're only going to be 3 letters long, so 3-letter words. Now, 3 members of the team are going to be over here, and they have to spell out each letter of that word with their bodies, right? Now, have a look down there with the camera, Bree. There's Adam Brand down there at the desk.
G'day, mate.
He's the one that has to guess what the word is.
That's exactly right. Now, the 3 members down here spelling the word out have to use their entire body. They're not allowed to use their fingers, they're not allowed to do sign language, and they're definitely not allowed to mouth the words. So we decided we'd kind of make it a bit harder for them and gaffer tape their mouths.
Gaffer tape their mouths, and they only have 2 minutes to get as many words as they want. Free the refugees. Back to you, Mikey.
Okay, they are the rules for the next round. Spelling bee. Because they lost the first round, the Idols will go second, which gives them extra time to talk tactics. How your team feeling down there? Fitzy.
Now, Jackie, your husband's up in the crowd. Give him a wave. Now, I was just having a chat to your husband there, Jack, and he said after this round, he wants you to keep the gaffer tape on when you go home. Jackie, we're going to do a warm-up. Give me a Y. M. C. Oh, she's down on the ground, and A. All right, get up you get, Jack. They are fired up. They've been talking tactics before they put the gaffer tape on. Mikey Goldman's down here with me.
Okay, yep, ready
Let's
to go.
Let's start it off.
Okay, fair enough. So it's the Bumpkins going first. Get ready, it's game on! Okay, first word. Oh. Go for it.
T-O-P, top.
Off to a good start, Fitzy, aren't they?
Why?
It's the village people.
U-M, yum.
Great start by the Bumpkins. Oh, this is a bit of a naughty room.
Really?
B-O. C.
She's going swimming. She wants to die.
Box. X. Box.
No, they've passed.
Oh. Did you make these words up, Mike, or what?
Why? I don't know. W-E-W-E-F. W-E. W-E-E. Hey, wait.
Nice.
Mike, if you have to go, there's a toilet out the back, right?
Why? E-T. Yet.
No.
L. U. Y, W, U. Why? What?
They can pass
why?
If they
pass,
want.
Pass.
You tell us why.
Good start by the Bumpkins, though. I'm impressed.
O, M, O. The moon.
That's not a word.
20 seconds to go. Come on, Mike can't write properly. 20 seconds to go.
O. I. Oil.
Yes.
Oh, nice.
Adam Brand, have a seat. I said have a seat, you naughty boy.
Oh, sorry, Mike, sorry.
Adam Brand, I think it was around about 4 or 5 words there. How did you find that? You're about 10 metres away. It was a bit tough to work it out, wasn't it?
Yeah, a couple of them are a bit scratchy, you know, but I think we did all right. We're going to have to see if the idols can spell or not, but good on you guys.
Well, if we have to see if the idols have to spell or not, I think we're going to be very confident. Mikey, back to you.
Okay, so the Country Bumpkins made 5 words in 2 minutes. I wasn't real good with the chalk, though, was I?
Was it only 5?
Only 5 words. You'd think I'd be better at writing on the chalkboard after all the lines I had to write at school. Can the Australian idols beat that?
Yes. Hey. Easy.
On Kids Sports Night, we're going off to practice our kissing technique behind the bike shed. This is Friday Night Games. Friday Night Games preliminary final. It's Junior Sports Night. I've just got to do a little roll call. Fitzy.
Present.
Bree.
Here.
Audience. The Country Bumpkins are fighting it out with the Idols for a place in our grand final and a huge check for $50,000 from Super Cheap Auto.
Thank you.
For the charity of their choice.
A huge check. How big's the check?
It's about 5 feet long and 2 foot wide. Very big.
Well, that's stupid then, because if they got $50,000, they're going to have to spend $20,000 on getting a massive wallet to put the check in.
Oh, you idiot.
That's just
okay,
dumb.
So now it's time for round two of SPELLINGBEE.
Mike, I told you not. Look, that was a mistake, all right?
Mate, I said spelling bee.
Oh, right. We only cuddled anyway. Look, sorry.
Sorry about him. He plays football. Okay, Bree's going down to the arena. It's time for the Idols to have their go, and they have a score of 5 words to beat. Over to you, Bree.
All right, so, Daniel, did you actually finish school or did you drop out to become a rock star? Yeah, right. And do you want to go out and get a couple of drinks tonight? Yeah, right. Good luck.
Part 2, Idols, you have 2 minutes. Get ready, it's game on!
P-O... Poo!
Yeah. Don't doubt it for a second, Millsy.
T-I... Tip!
Nice start! I'm very proud.
Good work, Ken. Go, Ken.
Good start by the Idols.
Jackson.
What is Daniel Spillane doing?
A rat.
Nice. Only a couple more to go, guys, and you got it.
L. That's a U or a V.
Dyslexic there, Daniel.
L. V. L.
No.
It's backwards, dude. I don't know what you're talking about. L.
No.
Pass, dude.
It's fast.
Not even
just over a minute to go.
I.
N-K.
Ink.
They only need W. one more to draw.
E.
E. We.
He's already done that one.
That's a Z. That's a S. Sit. Sit. Sit.
Sit. 30 seconds to go.
S. S. Y. H. Shy. Shy. S. Shy.
Shy. Definitely something that Millsy is not, is shy.
Y, U, V, V, A, N. Van, Van!
They are flying.
Yeah, got an A in bar. Yeah?
Ooh, ref.
That one's gonna count. I said bar before the siren. Come on, Breeskits. Help me out here. Does that count?
The last word bar got in just before the buzzer, giving the idols a total of 9. They've won the round.
Well, there you go. They got 9. Not bad.
Now, I heard, Millsy, earlier today you were bragging, saying that you thought you were a bit of a legend speller back at school. Is that right?
I was pretty good, but it's a bit tough. I thought it was going to be spelling words, not spelling people.
And spelling three-letter words at that. So you're pretty happy. I think this means that you guys have tied. So you still got all your confidence?
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I think we won that.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, but they won the first game, remember? Right. Remember that? You confident?
Excellent. I'm very pumped up, Breeze.
Excellent. Back to you, Mikey.
Well, there you go. Not a bad effort. So at the end of the spelling bee, the scores are level, Fitzy.
No good.
Next, we bring out the big guns to see who can conquer the mountain of knowledge.
Well, we'll see you after B-R-E-A-K.
Great. After the break, I'll get it.
After the break, yes, this is Friday Night Games. This is Fitzy, this is Bree. These are our country bumpkins, and these are our idols. Hey, hang on then. I said these are our country bumpkins, and they're all quiet. What happened?
They don't care, see?
Where's their cheer squad? Hey. Guys, I don't think you realise how massive this is. The Idols beat the Big Brother housemates to get here, and the Country Bumpkins beat the City Slickers. This is huge. The grand final is only in a few weeks' time. This is a highlight of their careers.
Yeah, definitely, Mikey. It's going to be a massive big grand final.
Okay, two teams, of course, battling it out for an ultimate prize of 50,000 big ones. Let's check out the scoreboard and have a look at how things are going so far. The country team, they won the first kids relay, 10 points. The idol team won 10 points in our second game. It's still very much anyone's game. As you'll remember, round 3 is worth a whopping 20 points. It's kids sports night, and it's time to find out who is the highest achiever in a game we call Highest Achiever.
Ooh. Achiever. Now, this game is worth 20 points, and it's as easy as this. Well, really, it's not easy, but the explanation is you got to run as hard and fast as you can all the way to the top of the mountain as high as you can go to get a grade to come all the way over here and stick on your report card.
Now
the top point is worth 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 as you go down.
Now, yeah, it sounds pretty easy, but this is a relay race. So one person, they take it in turns. One goes up. Yep. When they get back over the finish line, the next one goes up. Now, you've got to try and fill up your report card here. If you don't get a subject, You get 0 points for that subject. Mm. If you fill it up and you still have a bit of time left, which is 4 minutes, you can go and get higher ones and you can swap them over. Very tactical, Mike. Back to you.
Long way up, at last we have something taller than Fitzy. As the Idols won the last game, they have to go first, so bring any tactics with your Idol friends.
Now, guys, I think that this is going to be harder to get than a record deal. So, we've got to concentrate, all right? Millie, you're actually still in school, so does your report card, you know, how's that?
Oh, it's not looking too good at the moment, but we'll have to fix that tonight, I think.
Spending a little bit too much time doing stuff like this?
Yeah, just dagging around, you know.
Nice. And now, I have just heard, Christy, that you are absolutely terrified of heights. Is that true?
Yes, thank you.
And have you ever done anything like this before?
No.
You haven't? All right, guys, well, pump up. We've got to kick some butt. And you know, this is worth 20 points. It's very important. Good luck, and I'll see you after the game. Back to you, Mike.
Here we go. Anyone's game, the highest achiever. Idols, get ready. It's game on. Who's first up there, Fitzy?
Daniel Spillane, hitting Mount Everest.
Oh, he's just gone for the one.
Oh, well done, Daniel. That was very fearless.
A one in maths. That's not a very good score.
She's down already.
Christy's just done a hammy. She's just done a right
neck. She's doing it easy. She can go straight up. Good girl, Christy.
Oh, down she comes.
And you can't come back without a number.
She has to get a number before the next person can go. She has to at least get one. She's scared of heights.
Come on, Christy.
She's got one.
Beautiful.
One in Japanese and one in maths. Not doing too good.
Jeez.
That's worth the Saturday attention right there.
There goes Millie.
She can sing, but can she climb?
Only going one. They're playing it safe. They're playing it too safe.
Have a look at that report card. Actually, at school, my teacher said that I had to write a 500-word essay on anything, so I wrote it on her car with a coin.
Hey, Fitzy, that's looking a bit like your report card at the moment, isn't it?
Mate, I've got better grades. Oh, look at Millsy go.
Make sure you get the two.
Go for the five, Millsy.
He's still going.
He's a go at this kid. Look at him go. He's going to go all the way.
Millsy's actually been working out over the last 6 months, so it seems to be paying off.
It's another crowd.
Millsy just went higher than any single that he brought out, that's for sure. Daniel Spillane, he got a one last time. He's going for the two.
He's got a two. Nice work. Just get whatever you can, guys, and you can always replace him later.
At least they got a four in English. That's not bad.
Christy, the girl's scared of heights.
You'd expect an Australian Idol to get a four in English.
Seems to be a little bit slippery out there.
I see that they are. They got a one in PE over there, and that seems about right with how they're going at this, I think.
Get up there, get that one, Christy.
Come on, Christy, you can do it.
Bit slippery on that side, maybe.
Christy, our celeb to be.
And isn't she doing a good job for someone who's scared of heights?
All she wants is that one.
Jump.
But she's trying to get up there. She can't pass. She has to get at least something.
Push it on in, Christy.
Go, go. Come
on, Christy.
You have to go up. Get up there.
Oh, come on, come on.
Go, go, go.
Don't let the team down. You're the select to be.
You can do it. Believe in yourself.
You should be better than them all.
Just under a minute to go.
Can she get it? Get your arm up there, Christy. Just on 50 seconds to go.
Christy, the celeb to be, scared of heights, letting the whole nation down.
Come on.
Oh, Christy.
That's a bit harsh, mate.
No.
She's just getting a bad report card for the Idols. What would you do if you were here, Fitzy? Would you get a run up? How would you approach it?
He'd be able to reach it, Mike.
I think you've got to keep your feet pretty. It's a bit slippery out there, so you've got to keep your feet a bit dry and your hands. You've got to get a good grip.
really wants to put a 10 here.
Oh, that's it.
Oh, no.
Come over here, Christy. Come over here, Dom. How are you feeling? A bit responsible, maybe?
Oh, totally let down.
It's okay. Look, no worries. It looked extremely difficult, and I have played this game myself, and I know exactly how hard it is. But there's still
a chance.
Well,
you get up there, Bree, and have a go now.
Yeah,
you're
go
so
on,
good.
Bree.
Go on,
Bree. 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 Okay. Bree. Bree.
No.
Bree.
No. 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 No.
Weak.
No, no, I can't. I'm not going to embarrass myself.
She just doesn't want to muck up her hair.
How about we go to the ref for the score, hey?
Okay, ref, give us the score, will you?
Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 7, 9.
Whoa. 9.
That's not too bad. It's not too bad.
I don't know about you, Fitzy, but if that was my report card, I'd get a detention.
That was and what about Bree getting stuck into her own team? Oh, they're going downhill
well,
now.
The Country Bumpkins have got 9 points to beat. Let's have a little look at the replay of Millsy climbing up there. He got the highest.
Yes.
Did a bloody good job, don't you reckon?
Well done, Millsy. He was getting higher than Courtney Love.
There we go. Oh, that was a massive stack there. Good on you, Millsy, getting right up the top there. Okay, if you're not back in a few minutes, I'll tell my mummy on you. It's Kids Sports Night. This is Friday Night Games. Welcome back to Friday Night Games. I don't think I need to tell you how much fun it's been because you've seen it. And I'm not a dobber. This is the first preliminary final at the end of tonight. We'll have our first grand finalists on Friday Night Games. At the moment, the scores are level. So anyone has got it tonight, it's all up for grabs. And the Country Bumpkins are just about to play part two of Highest Achiever. How are they going to do, Fitzy?
Right, I'm down here with my team. Do not forget that there's 20 points up for grabs here. And look, Adam Brand, can we just have another quick look at that report card of the idols there? Mate, they're right here behind you. Anything you want to say to these people?
Yes, idols, an SMS ain't going to save you tonight, all right?
Oi! Adam Brand wants to vote off the idols tonight, and I reckon they've only got to beat a score of 9, Mikey. I think we've got it in the bag.
Okay, well, we'll see. It's Highest Achiever Part 2. Country Bumpkins, get ready! It's game on! There we go. First up there.
It's Adam. Adam's first up on the mountain.
Adam Brand, climbing the mountain. I'm sure he's got a song about that called Climbing the Mountain.
Oh, he's held on well, Adam. He's getting higher. Listen to the crowd getting behind him. Keep going, Adam.
He's doing a Millsy.
He's got a four. Is he going for the five?
The five.
Get out.
He's got the five. Adam Brand, what an effort.
Hey, Mikey.
Well done, son.
He went so high, he's going to come down with snow on his head.
Oh. In maths.
Hey, the higher you get, the better the grade. It's a bit like art college.
Hey, have a look at the sheer.
Here comes a great artistic person. It's Glennie. He's been known to shear his sheep into the shape of a Picasso painting.
Look at the shearer go.
They've already won.
Hey,
these guys are almost ahead already.
It's a tie. So they've got to suck for the rest of the time.
Yeah.
Hopefully they won't be able to get past the bottom rung now.
It's tied, so really, Wendy from Australia brings us only needs one.
Get in the queue. Hey, Glenn, come here, Glenn. Mate, Glenn and Adam Brand They should have been... Daniel Spillane said over there before, they're not from the country, they're monkeys, they're from the forest, they're from the Amazon. Mate, the strength in your legs, is that from shearing?
Yeah, a bit of shearing, bit of growing up, big national park, a few mountains.
What, you've climbed a few walls to get away from the cops as well, have you?
Yeah, a few.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's go have a look at the report card with the ref.
5, 9, 10!
You little beauty!
Hang on a sec. Great score. Very good. You've got to give it to him.
Fitzy was so keen to get me up there. Go on. Give it a go.
Do you want me to have a crack?
Oh, actually, wait.
Go, Fitzy.
Go on, Mikey. You get down there.
Oh, he's hopeless. I could beat that.
Go on. Get down there.
I'm going to have a go.
Go. Go on. Race to the top, boys. Race to the top. Go.
I'll get back up. I'll get
ready. Come on, Fitzy, you're embarrassing your girlfriend.
Did I win?
No, you won.
I think it was about even. Okay, let's take a look at the replays of the Country Bumpkins. The great effort that they went to win that round of Highest Achiever. Look at Adam Brand. Didn't he do great?
Great job. What a good effort.
It is hard climbing up there, and it's a little bit slippery too. I don't know if it's sweat on there.
Oh, Mikey.
Or what it
is. Don't make excuses for how bad
you were. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. Here we go. At the moment, the Country team are leading with 30 points.
There is still opportunity for the Idols to come back and win, and I have a good feeling about the last round.
The Idol team are only on 10 points. Can you believe we're only one game away from finding out who will be the first team to reach the Friday Night Games Grand Final?
And the last round, ready for it, is worth 40 points.
40 points? Hey, yes. One team tonight is about to go home happier than a fat man at a pipe factory. Just one more team. Woo! I lost my breath. Both have given in everything they've got, but it's the next game that separates the prefects from the dunces. Don't go away, this is Friday Night Games.
In the final game, the teams are too busy trying to win to worry about who's going to the ball.
Friday Night Games. I'm Mike Goldman, this is Fitzy, this is Bree, and this is our audience. It's show and tell time here on Kids Sports Night. We put on a show that tells you who's the first team to get through to the grand final. One thing you've learned about Friday Night Games is we save the best till last, and the preliminary finals are no different. How are the teams going, guys? Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, we are on fire at the moment, Mikey. I think it's 30 to 10 now. We worked it out here, me and Bree, before. Yeah. Your team has to win, Bree. Even if you're tied, we are the winners.
Yeah, because I'm on a massive 10 points, but I have confidence, you know. I've been down there, we've been talking tactics, and I think we've got some good ideas.
You've just been talking up, Millsy. You haven't been talking up tactics.
Well, you know, anything could happen here tonight with a massive 40 points on the line. There's everything to play for. And let me tell you, the winner of the next game will definitely be the team who has the most balls. You'll see what I mean in the final game. Schoolyard tug of war!
Final round, 40 points up for grabs. And I tell you what, Bree, either team wins, they take out the whole night.
Feel the
tension. Settle down, you guys. Listen up.
Settle down.
I'm telling you the rules. They're firing up.
Now, this is the schoolyard tug of war. It's pretty basic, right? They are joined by bungee rope in the middle. What they have to do, each team has to get down to either end and grab these balls here, right? Simple as that. Grab the ball, come back here, and what you have to do is chuck the ball into this cage here.
Yeah, well, it's not quite as simple as that, Fitzy, because when they grab the ball, they have to pass it through every teammate, and only the person at the back can shoot the ball. Now, they have to shoot it into their colour-coded cage, and if it lands in and bounces out, unlucky. Back to you, Mike.
Okay, this is it. The team that wins this goes through to the grand final. So the aim of the game is to collect as many balls as you can and place them in your basket whilst making it as hard as possible for the other team. I want a clean, fair fight. Fitzy, Bree, how are they going to do it?
All right, guys, this is payback time. Payback time. I want you pumped. I want you angry. Who are you after? Who do you want to injure?
No one, I just want to get the ball.
That's very passive of you.
I tell you what, the country bumpkins don't want a good clean fight. They want a scrag and they want to be dirty the whole time. Have a look at them go. Hey, let's just get it underway, will you?
This is the schoolyard tug of war. Get ready, it's game on. A good start. The Idols have got the first ball, but can they get it into their basket?
Good start, Idols. Pass that ball back. Pass that ball back.
Country Bumpkins haven't even got themselves a ball yet.
Yeah,
that's great for the Idols.
Yeah, go Idols.
One step closer to the grand final. Have a look at this. One all. Nice shot.
Bounced out. Millie has actually played basketball growing up. That's why they've got her in the shooting position, which is very smart.
There we go. Another shot. Nice one, Millie. Bit of spin on that.
Beautiful. They've got the great tactics going here.
Net. The Idols are way ahead.
This is a good effort by the Idols. They've got three in there already.
If the Bumpkins don't get any in, that's it for them.
That's it. They're doing better now, the country Bumpkins. They're getting it back. You got to get down on your knees, Glenn. Get down on your knees.
Yes, very nice one. That's four to the Idols. Bumpkins won.
Oh, they've got a good anchor at the end there with Spillane.
Dan Spillane said he's been sitting around home writing songs.
It's out. That's all right. There's still five ahead.
Dan reckons he's put on a bit of weight, so he's a good anchor man.
I tell you what, Glenn. Glenn might have to get down on his knees. Get down on your knees, son, and crawl. That's
all
it, Glenn,
the country Bumpkins have to do is get the same amount of balls, and then they're through to the final. Millie, that's like the
it,
third
Glenn.
One you missed.
Crawl your way up, Glenn. That's it, son. Keep going.
Don't give up.
That's it. Keep crawling.
Only a minute to go.
A minute to go. That's it. Glenn's got it. Pass it down.
The secret to the game.
Be holding on to that.
The secret to the game is to not.
Jackie's got to get it in.
Others get to the balls.
Jackie's got to get it in.
Don't be giving up, Idols.
Two to the Bumpkins. Oh, what's the ref doing?
There's another one to the Bumpkins.
Three to the Bumpkins.
Here they come. 30 seconds to go.
Jackie.
All they're going to do is tie. They need one more to tie. Turn around. Wendy, you guys, you know they had about five in their cage and you only had one in there. There was about a minute to go. That is the biggest comeback I've ever seen in my life.
Country heart, mate.
Yeah. Country heart. Anything you want to say to the country people out there, Adam Brand?
Thanks for getting behind us. You
We're
pulled
doing
us
it for you.
Through.
We're doing it for you. What a comeback, Mike. Back to you.
It's getting up there. Well, we're going to get the balls counted by the referee right now. So over to the ref.
Okay, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the goal team. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the goal.
Incredible performance from the country bumpkins. Let's take a look at the replay. Incredible performance. Look at this, crawling along the mat there, trying the sheer desperation of the country team. And look at that shot. Jackie Asalatabi from the country bumpkins. Incredible performance. Okay, so let's take a look at the scoreboard right now. It stands.
We have to.
The country team on 70 and the idol team on 10. So country team are in our grand final. Mate, Bree is down there with the losers tonight, the idols. Bree, what's going on?
Guys, that was such a good effort. Like, it was so, so close. You couldn't have asked for a better game. How are you feeling?
Nothing left in the tank, but that was so much fun. Congratulations, guys. Go hard in the final. Good on you.
Oh, see that? Good sportsmanship. Yeah, group hug. Come on, group hug.
Incredible performance. Let's see the report card of the winners' achievements tonight.
Oh, good start.
This time's pretty good. This is going to be close.
No.
Hey, wait.
He's getting higher. Listen to the crowd getting behind him. He's got the fire. Look at the Shearer go.
If the Bumpkins don't get any in, that's it for them. Oh, my God. The idols came second. You guys must be stoked.
Yes.
Well, you made it this far, but you're not going home empty-handed, oh no!
Each of our brave celebrities will take home a Fitness First Platinum Gym membership, along with a Fitness First starter pack with everything they'll need to get the ball rolling. With over 54 locations across Australia, they'll have no excuse to ever lose again. Our preliminary finalist, Celeb TV, will take home the latest in video and audio technology. And we're not talking about ridiculous earplugs. We're talking about the new Altec Lansing IM5 in-motion portable speaker system, along with the new Apple Video iPod. Now you can watch a video or listen to your favourite music out loud. Thanks to Audion Australia. You are out of applause. All right, and congratulations through to the grand final, the Country Bumpkins. Mate, you guys will be joined by the next two winning teams in the grand final in a few weeks from now. You've gone through now twice undefeated, and here's another trophy for you to
stick. Here's another trophy in the cabinet for the Country Bumpkins. Well done, guys.
Two for the Country Bumpkins. That's it for this week. School is out. Thank you, Pixie. Thank you, Bree. Thank you, Ref. Thank you, audience. We'll see you next week when it's Pirate Night. Hurry, me hearties. On Friday Night Games. Good night! Dream World, the home of Friday Night Games.